Hi everyone, Kristen Hawthorne here, exclusive Black Status presenter with Unique. And today I'm going to talk to you about motivating your teens. So many times I get emails from my team members saying, oh my gosh, how do I motivate my team? So-and-so is not doing anything. What do I do? And I know as leaders, it's frustrating, right? We see so much potential in people, and so it really can be frustrating. But we post successful images, success quotes, we share stories with people, and yet they're still sitting at zero sales. So, and we've all been there, we start thinking, oh my gosh, it's me. I'm doing something wrong. I'm not a good leader. So what do we do then? We run over to everyone sitting at zero and we pump them up. How can I help you? What can I do? And they get a little bit of motivation out of that, right? So we go to the next person and we do the same thing. We pump them up. Hey, I'm here for you. How can I help you? How can we get sales going? And they, you know, they get full of air too. So they start rising up off the ground a little. So you go over, you know, to five more team members and do the same thing. And you're thinking, all right, this is what I was doing wrong. I wasn't reaching out personally to everyone. You know, I wasn't trying to help everyone on my team. But then you notice that first person that you pumped up, they're starting to deflate. So you run back over to them. Hey, what's going on? You know, your sales are dipping again. Like, what's happening? And then they tell you, oh, it's just so hard. I just don't know what to do. So, you know, you pump them up again. Then you notice that all of the other team members, same thing. They're all starting to deflate. So you run over, keep pumping them up, right? Meanwhile, no one's team is growing. Everything's probably pretty much at a standstill. And you're exhausted. You're exhausted of trying to motivate the unmotivated. And that's the thing right there. Not everyone wants what we want. There's a small percentage of us that want the top of the comp plan, that want to be at the top of the company, you know, that want to make a ton of money so we can have an extra house or pay for our college tuition for our children or, you know, just put a ton of money in savings. But not everyone wants that. Sometimes an extra, you know, $300 so that someone can go to the grocery store is all they sign up to do. That is their goal. And you know what? That's totally okay. Not everyone has, you don't have to have the same goals as everyone on your team. But what you need to do as a leader is to work with the ones that are emerging as leaders, right? So you look at your team, if someone's sitting at zero, you don't want to have to keep pumping them up full of air. You want to work with the person who is rocking it and has an amazing month with sales. Or you want to work with the ones who have recruited 20 people this month because it's like a light bulb going off, right? They want it. They want to be at the top. They are emerging as leaders, and you want to reach out to those people and say, hey, awesome job. Like, how can I help you? You know, let's really rock this and get you to the next promotion. Meanwhile, the ones that aren't motivated, that's okay still. It's okay. Everyone, you know, you need a little bit of everyone on your team. You let those people know, hey, I'm still here if you need anything. But you let them be. You let them, you know, you leave them alone until they come to you and they need something. And oftentimes, maybe their situation changes. Maybe they realize, huh, I have what it takes. You know, they get that confidence. Like, maybe I could be, you know, at the top of the company. Maybe I could be a Black Status presenter. So then they come to you and say, hey, I realize I haven't been, you know, working it is hard, but I want this now. How can we form a game plan together? How can you help me? And then you start helping them. So I just want you to remember that this whole network marketing industry, it's just a numbers game. Okay, you might sign up 100 personally sponsored, but not all 100 are going to do anything. And that's okay, again. You know, the great multimillionaire from Amway, Bill Britt, he showed the Amway opportunity to 1,200 people. Out of those 1,200, 900 people told him no. Out of those, I mean, the rest, I can't do my math there. So 300 people said yes. Out of those 300, 85 people actually did something. Out of those 85, 35 really emerged as leaders. And out of those 35, 11 people made him a multimillionaire. So just keep working, just keep recruiting, keep selling, keep sharing the opportunity, and remember it's a numbers game. You don't need everyone to be as motivated as you are. But what you need to do as a leader is to see the ones that are emerging and work with them.